la gauche et la droite qui ont marqué sur Ricky. Ricky, on voit ici ce recul et il est vulnérable dans ça. Là, ses deux gants sont en bas et il est vulnérable sur l'attaque de Shin. On va voir un peu peut-être les coups de maintenant de... Regardez, la droite ici. Oh. Parve ici, juste sur le... Voilà. Des pertes d'équilibre de la part de M. Shin.
Round numéro 2 chez les 75 kilos Joon-Sup Shin de la Corée contre Rick Duff du Canada. Les deux ont été victorieux à une première tentative. Et là, c'est Shin tout de suite qui commence en prenant l'initiative. Il place un coup, Duff lui qui recule lentement mais sûrement et qui tente maintenant de placer sa gauche ou sa droite à lui. Charmant jeune homme sur Rick Duff avec qui nous avons pu nous entretenir assez longuement.
Alors, si vous remarquez la différence notoire entre les deux, c'est que Shin ne plie, n'envoie jamais sa tête ou son corps vers l'arrière, même attaqué. Il va bouger de gauche à droite, alors que Ricky, lui, lorsqu'il est attaqué, recule complètement le corps vers l'arrière et est vulnérable à ce moment-là à des crochets de gauche ou de droite.
Autre chose qu'il faut noter, c'est que Shin boxe au bout du bras, complètement. Ça veut dire que sa longue portée lui permet des fois de passer au travers celle de Rick Duff. Vous avez vu cette gauche qui est entrée là.
Et vous avez vu...
Alors, Duff qui est obligé de reculer aussi. Hein.
Oui, à nouveau ici.
Et il évite bien. Il évite bien. Et voilà, là, par exemple, il vient d'absorber une gauche, mais tout de suite, riposte avec une droite.
Et vous avez remarqué, Shin a respecté ici, n'a pas voulu aller en contre-corps. Ça c'est tout à l'avantage de Ricky. C'est bon signe. C'est parce qu'il ne se sent pas bien en contre-corps contre lui.
Exactement. Et il connaît aussi la puissance de frappe de Joon-Sup Shin.
Oh! Et deux voilà, coups de poing après, stop, et
maintenant,
deux coups de poing après.
C'est M. Guacchi d'Italie. Ah,
la foule ici,
là, naturellement,
ici, eut de son mécontentement, mais il les a pris quand même, les deux coups de poing maintenant.
Ben, je pense que ce n'était peut-être pas intentionnel, mais encore là, Ricky a fait une erreur monumentale. Il a regardé l'arbitre, et c'est une chose qu'on ne doit jamais faire en boxe amateur. Pour laquelle on ne regarde pas l'arbitre.
Et vous savez que les juges, un juge qui voudrait enlever un point à cause de ça peut le faire, même si l'arbitre, lui, ne pas.
Oh! Et là, Duff a finalement évité. Et là, tout de suite, il décide de mélanger avec Shin.
Il a bien recruté, mais c'est un encaisseur, ce Ricky Duff. Regardez la gauche, les gauches qu'il a pris. Il est rouge du côté droit maintenant. Et il continue d'attaquer quand même. Et la foule ici hurle.
Et Rick Duff aimerait bien mélanger, je pense, avec Joon-Sup Shin. Mais ce dernier ne veut pas absolument aller dans les corps à corps.
Non.
C'est la longue portée qui veut gagner sa bataille.
Oui, il connaît la force de sa gauche et veut l'utiliser avec en utilisant son jab de droit, puis avec sa gauche pour aller essayer de vraiment faire mal à Ricky Duff.
Et voilà. Tout de suite, Rick Duff qui tente la riposte d'esquive par le Coréen. C'est bien fait, mais on sent qu'il y en a une qui s'en vient. Voilà. C'était passé par Shin, une bonne gauche acceptée par Ricky Duff. Encore une fois, cette fois, c'est la droite qui...
C'est une bonne gauche ici de la part de Ricky, oui.
Tout de suite qu'on a, aussitôt qu'on accroche, c'est Ricky Duff qui prend l'initiative.
Oui, Ricky, s'il était capable de se battre davantage à l'intérieur, s'il n'y avait pas cette mauvaise habitude de se reculer vers l'arrière, il pourrait se battre à l'intérieur et il serait sûrement avantagé dans le combat.
Excellent combat à venir jusqu'ici. Belle performance du Canadien, round numéro 2 qui prend fin. Et on vous parle toujours, bien entendu, directement du Sports Arena.
Cut the instructions.
Okay, those instructions from Kai Yip, the coach from Lethbridge. You see the Korean delegation, which lives in the upper bowl here at the LA Memorial Arena and has since the boxing competition began. Very vocal, very enthusiastic.
Yes.
And at the far end, you saw Canadian coach Taylor Gordon and some of his associates waving the Canadian flag.
Kai Yip was asking there whether Rick is hurt, and he said, no, I'm not. And he said, all right, now it's time to go to work. It's time to hit to the body. It's time to start throwing that leather and take it to the Korean. And that is the answer. That's what I would tell him to do, and that's what Kai Yip has done.
The bell sounds, or rather the electronic tone that supplements the ordinary ring bell here at the arena. Round three of this middleweight contest underway. Earlier today, the lightweights in the spotlight, an impressive showing by Canada's John Colbin. Rick Duff now looking to advance to the third round in the middleweight competition following a preliminary win earlier in the week over Australian Brendan Cannon.
Rick must keep that hand up. He must keep his hand up. He's getting caught with that jab. The Korean is not beating him by much, but he is scoring that jab very cleanly. He must keep that hand up. He must get inside now and go to work, or he's going to drop a decision.
The Korean throwing the stronger punches, the better scoring punches. Rick Duff's face now reddening. He's taken some hard blows, and although he told his coach Kai Yip between rounds that he was not hurt, he is losing on points. He has to be losing on points at this stage of the fight. With 2 minutes to go, Rick Duff has to come on.
He does. I believe he's not afraid of Shin at all. I believe that his tactic is to try to counterpunch against Shin right now, and really his instructions are to come on, take the attack to Shin, and that's what he should be doing. He has to. He got caught with a very strong left hand. I don't believe he was hit and hurt, but I believe that the Italian is giving him the benefit of the doubt and giving him an eight count.
Well, of course, safety first and foremost in the minds of all officials at the boxing venue. If they even suspect that a man may have been hurt, they will administer the eight count. If they feel he cannot continue, they will call the bout off.
It's still only one scoring blow in the scoring of things, and it really stands for nothing more than just that.
Coach Kai Yip telling Rick Duff between rounds to move inside, to work to the body. Rick not having much success doing that so far. You can see he elects to stay on the outside in no man's land, in boxing jargon, just where the Korean boxer wants it.
The Korean is concentrating on a power stance on Rick. What he's doing is just setting up on a power stance and really letting it rip as hard as he can, trying to score the hardest shot he can inside to take Rick out. Rick has to get a little bit on the inside now. Really, he should be getting on the inside and working there. But Shin is very, very strong. Very, very strong on the inside.
And now the Korean delegation once again begins the chant from the upper bowl. The Canadians exhorting Rick Duff from their section at the end of the arena. 39 seconds showing on the clock in round three. Rick Duff supposedly behind. I suspect he's behind on points. And the Korean still the aggressor, still coming on as he's done since the opening seconds of round one.
He's got nothing to lose now. He's got to shoot the works. He's got 25 seconds left in this fight. He should go for it. He must realize there's very little time. He's come back with a hard left hand there, but he has to take the fight to Shin. He's not ahead on points here. He must come forward. But I guess he just cannot do it. Shin may be just too strong for him on the outside.
Shin obviously forcing Rick Duff to respect his punching power. 5 seconds to go. Now four, now three. It ticks down. This fight all over as signified by the electronic bell. And it does not look good for Canada's Rick Duff. A gutsy performance, but a performance I do not believe, Peter Wiley, that will be good enough to advance him to the next round.
I would agree. I would think that he would have dropped the 5-0 decision there. He put out a great effort. There's no doubt about it. He's a very gutsy individual. He always puts out 110% interest, 110% effort. He's never been known for anything else, and he did it here. He just had to come on a lot more in that fight. He had to take the fight to Shin, and he didn't do that.
Los Angeles.
Our referee, Luigi Quacci of Italy, also a seasoned individual in terms of amateur boxing. We are waiting for the decision. It's gone from the judges to the jury, who will check the scores, and we are expecting an announcement here momentarily. In the meantime, I can tell you that our lightweight, John Calvin of Toronto, was a most impressive winner earlier tonight. Well, on the early round of boxing this morning, our super heavyweight, Lennox Lewis, after a comparatively slow start, came on with a dynamite knockout punch in the third round to stop his opponent from Pakistan. Lewis to go on in his next round to face the current world champion Tyrell Biggs of the United States, who was also a winner today. Now, here's our decision on the middleweight bout. Yes, no question about it. It is Joon-Sup Shin of Korea, the winner by virtue of a 4-1 decision. So he will advance. And for Canada's Rick Duff, Peter Wiley, unfortunately, it's over.
Yes, it is. He did put up a good performance, and he has a future in international boxing. There's no doubt about it. He represented Canada very well. It was only a 4-1 split decision.
So three Canadian boxers in action today. As I mentioned, John Calvin, the lightweight, Lennox Lewis, the super heavy, winning. Rick Duff, not so fortunate. He is out in the middleweight division.